To be able to analyze text with all available statistical and machine learning techniques, we must first prepare our data by converting the text into a numeric representation. In this video, we'll present common steps of text data preparation. As in every data project, the first step here is to read the data. We might have many different types of text data available to us. For example, our data could consist of reviews in a CSV file, comments in an Excel file, a book in EPUB format, or even several PDF documents. Important for text mining with KNIME Analytics platform is a special cell type called a document, which contains the tokenized text. In a document, the smallest unit is a token, which is normally one word. In addition to several tokens, documents also contain meta information like title, author, and tags. The next step after reading is the enrichment step, by adding tags to each token within the documents. I often think of tags as post-its that I can add to each token in a document. There are different types of tags, each with different tag values. We can tag the documents with a tag of type sentiment, based on sentiment dictionaries that are freely available from academic literature. Another common task in text analysis is to tag words according to their part of speech and grammar role. Regardless of the tagging method that we choose, a token with a tag is called a term. The aim of the next step is to reduce the number of different tokens in the document corpus by both deleting unnecessary tokens and normalizing the tokens. Why do we want to do this? Well, ultimately, we want to reduce complexity before we convert our corpus into a sparse mathematical representation in order to decrease processing time later on. One filtering method we could use involves excluding all stop words, which are very common words that contribute little meaning to the text, such as and or the. Another frequently used approach is to make use of the tags from the enrichment step to filter only terms with a certain tag type and tag value. For example, only those with a part of speech tag and tag type adjective. Another option to reduce the number of different tokens in the document corpus is normalization. Common normalization techniques include case conversion, stemming, and limitization. Stemming is the shortening of words, often from differing parts of speech, into a single term that carries a similar idea. The idea is to reduce the number of individual terms in the corpus without losing meaning in the text, by grouping tokens with similar meanings into one. Limitization is a similar approach, retaining human-readable words instead of stem terms, but still reducing the overall feature space. The next step in the text analysis process is the transformation step. Our goal at this step is to convert the text in our corpus into a numerical representation that algorithms can work with. Common techniques are to create a bag of words or create a document vector using term frequencies. A bag of words for one document is simply a list of terms that are in the document after all pre-processing and cleaning has been performed. With a bag of words representation, you lose some information in your text, like word order, but you can still calculate term frequencies. Based on these frequency values, you could, for example, create a word cloud of relevant terms using the frequency for the font size to visually represent which terms are more common. A document vector, on the other hand, is a numerical representation of a document in its corpus, where each term that occurs in the corpus becomes a feature. Each document is represented by a vector encoding whether or not a term of the corpus is present or not using one hot encoding. You can see that if you don't clean up your corpus properly in the preceding steps, this can lead to a huge feature space, as each term in the corpus becomes one column. You also have the option here to use term relative frequencies in place of one hot encoded values. Let's summarize. Common pre-processing steps in a text mining project are 1. Reading data using tokenization. 2. Enrichment by adding tags. 3. Cleaning and normalization to reduce the number of different terms and delete unnecessary information. And lastly, 4. Transformation. Generally speaking, once you have a numerical representation for your documents, you have at your fingertips the full power of KNIME Analytics platform to train classification models, cluster documents, and visualize the data as you see fit.